There's something alive in the Gowanus Canal, and we're going to find out what it is. I'm Molly, and we are back in New York for this episode with our super special guest, Sally Waring.
Hello.
Sally is a PhD candidate at New York University, where she studies the biology of parasitic protists. And you may have seen some of her photos and videos of non-parasitic protists living in the waters of New York in her awesome Instagram account, Pond Life, Pond Life. And you should check out the link in the description. So, what's a protist?
A protist is a term, or an old term, for a group of organisms.
So all of life can be divided up into six kingdoms. We have the archaea, the bacteria, the fungi, the plants, and the animals. And the sixth kingdom was protists. So anything that didn't fit into one of those other five kingdoms was lumped into the kingdom protist. The kingdom protist isn't really used anymore. It's now been divided up into multiple different subgroups. But the term protist is still quite useful to describe the kinds of organisms that we're going to see today.
So what does a protist actually look like?
They're mostly unicellular, which means they're made up of only one cell. They're also microscopic, so we need a microscope to look at them. There's some exceptions to this rule, so giant kelp is an exception, it's a protist. Other protists include slime molds, amoebas, and some parasites as well, so the malaria parasite is a protist.
All right, so I want to find a protist. Where do they live?
So you can look just about anywhere. They exist in any environment on Earth. They live in the soil, some live in our own bodies, and they can exist in any body of water. So the ocean, ponds, rivers, and even the Gowanus Canal.
So what do we need to do to find out what protists are living in the Gowanus Canal?
Well, we're gonna take this jar, we're gonna fill it with Gowanus Canal water, and then we're gonna put it on a microscope and take a look.
Let's do it.
Have a look at some of the things that we've got here. So this looks like a green algae.
Yeah.
And we've got something else which looks suspiciously like a jellyfish.
Definitely not a protist.
All right, so we're gonna have a look. So we have our sample here, and we have this slide. And the slide has, if you can see, a little cavity in it.
Oh, yeah.
And so we can hold some water on this slide. We also have a cool little microscope. So this is a Newton portable field microscope. So it's a full light microscope that you can use in the field. Okay, so I'm gonna pipette some water out of this jar and onto our slide. And last of all, we put a cover slip over top. And that's gonna keep the water still on that slide. And there we have a micro sample of the Gowanus Canal. All right, so let's put it on our microscope. We're starting off at 100x magnification. This microscope also has a 400x magnification lens. And then we have this cool little adapter. So this is my iPhone in this little adapter. And this slides over the eyepiece of the microscope.
So we
can record and we can project what we see onto the iPhone
Amazing,
screen.
Amazing, yeah.
Okay, so this is a diatom. Diatoms are species of unicellular algae, and they live in a glass shell called a frustule. So they build it themselves. They collect silica from their environment and build this beautiful glass structure around their cells. It helps to keep them safe from predators and from drying out.
So gorgeous.
So that's the green algae there that we could see in the jar.
Right. So that's an example of a protist that we can see with our
Own eyes, yeah. It's also an example of a multicellular protist as well. So there's many cells here joined together. While those diatoms that we were looking at were unicellular protists. That's a little bacterium, I think.
Oh, yeah.
They're much smaller than the protists. So protists have compartmentalized cells. So their DNA is stored in a nucleus. Bacteria have no compartments within their cell. So that's our flagellate.
Flagellate is a word for any organism that has a flagellum, and it's a structure that sticks out either the front or the back of the cell, and the cell uses it to pull or push itself through the water by moving that flagellum about.
She's not going anywhere. It's around and around in circles.
This one's stuck in place.
Oh no. Look, there we go.
Yep, she's off.
Okay.
This is one of my favorite organisms. It's a diatom called Bacillaria. It's also known as the Carpenter's Rule diatom. It's a colony. That means that there's multiple individuals living together here as one unit, but the cells use each other to move the colony around.
Alright, so we saw some diatoms and some green algae and some flagellates. Is this kind of what you were expecting?
So these are the kinds of life forms that I see when I look at bodies of fresh water all over New York City. It is a little unexpected for us to find these life forms in the Gowanus Canal because the Gowanus Canal is thought to be this very toxic environment where not many life forms can thrive. But microorganisms are like this, right? They can thrive where other organisms cannot.
So are all the little organisms that we saw today going to be on Pond Life?
Yeah, they are, of course. So Pond Life is all about showing people who don't usually get to see microorganisms all the microorganisms that exist all around us. So they exist in our parks and in our polluted canals, and they're beautiful creatures and they have complex lives, and I wanted people to be able to see that with their own eyes.
Well, Sally, thank you so much for being on Science in Real Life, and we are so excited about Pond Life. And here's another reminder to subscribe to Pond Life on Instagram. Just click the link in the description below, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks for coming along.